Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Daphne. If you're new here, welcome, bienvenue, and thank you for clicking on today's video. As you can see by the title, today we're doing a huge collective haul. I have a lot of things from shoes to bags, sunglasses, jewelry, perfume. We got all the things, girl. So don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe down below. Share this video with your friends and family if you find it helpful, of course. Now let's get into it. I'm going to start with shoes. I got three pairs of shoes. That's not three. Three pairs of shoes to share with you guys. The first one from Nike. They're just some simple white sneakers. I do have my Pumas and I love them very much. I have another pair from Nike that I don't wear as much, but I wanted something that was very nice. I was leaning towards the Air Force Ones, but I felt like they were just a little too bulky for me. So I got something that is pretty similar. I'll put the exact name on the screen for you guys and also down below. They're just some white sneakers, just regular white sneakers. They look like a woman version of an Air Force One, if that makes sense. So I absolutely love these. I haven't worn them yet, but I've had them for about 2 months. I've still been wearing my Pumas because I really, really, really love those. My Carinas, but these are also very nice. And you can have these and wear them during summer. Summer is almost gone, but definitely you can wear this in fall, winter, spring. Just have this for a while in your collection. So these are pretty good. They were not super expensive either. The next shoe that I have to share with you guys is from Saint Laurent. I am super, super, super excited. These are just another color of the Tribute sandals that I have the white one in. These are a dark nude pinkish color and a patent leather. It comes with two dust bags, and I got it in my normal size 8. I haven't worn these yet, you guys, but these are it. I think they're super cute, super girly. I absolutely love these shoes. I think these are the type of shoes that you can wear in the office on a Friday because they do look a little dressier than maybe a Tory Burch sandal or something like that. So these are the sandals. Like I said, I got them in a size 38, my normal size. I find that these run true to size for me. If you have larger feet, maybe you might want to size up, but my feet are more on a narrow normal side, so these are super cute and I cannot wait to wear them. I got these from Farfetch, and yeah, for some reason, right? Okay, you guys, so I don't know if you saw Aaliyah's face vlog where she has the Bottega sandals and where it was supposed to be sewn on over here, it was literally glued on. Like, this was coming undone. I can do the same with these. These are brand new, you guys. I have not worn them yet, but look, do you see the thread? It's supposed to be sewn on, right? Or no? I don't know, you guys. I don't know if I'm going to return these and try to get another pair, or if I'm just going to keep them and maybe get reinforcement from my shoe cobbler. Wow, such a disappointment. Anyway, yeah, I was so happy to get these shoes, but I haven't worn them, and like, I can already see the dent over here, like it's coming off. I'm gonna check my white ones to see if they do the same. Anyway, these are the shoes. You guys know I really, really love these. They're super cute, very nice, comfortable enough. They're not the kind of shoe you wanna wear and walk around town, go to the mall, go here, go there, but they're cute for brunch. They're cute for like 1 to 2 stops at a, you know, at the mall, but not if you're spending your whole day shopping. But they're pretty comfortable, if that makes sense, you know? Yeah, let's move on to the next. My next pair that I have to show you guys is from Bottega Veneta. These shoes I've already worn, and if you guys have seen my styling video, my style inspo video, I'll link it up here for you guys to check out. I styled these in that video. These are the stretch sandals. It has the little woven detail right here. I absolutely love it. I feel like it gives vacation vibes, but you can also wear it year round. I really like these. They're pretty comfortable, very stylish, very nice. I got them from the Bottega website. I got these in a size 39 just to be safe because I wasn't sure about the sizing, and they fit perfectly. This is the color cane sugar, I believe. And yeah, I absolutely love these, you guys, and I plan on getting more. I really want a black one. I don't really love all of the Bottega shoes. I don't like all of them, but I feel like this one is still trendy, but it can still pass as a classic shoe because it's just a strappy sandal. Strappy sandals, I feel like, in my opinion, will always be in style. So definitely I love this. I do want a black one, and maybe in the future get other colors, but yeah. Okay, that's it for shoes. We're gonna get into bags and small leather goods. One of them is one that I've already showed you guys. It is my 6-key holder from Louis Vuitton. This one is fairly new. I got it not too long ago. You guys have seen this. I absolutely love it. It carries my keys, and I have some cards also. I talked about this a little bit more in my best luxury purchases under $500. I'll link it up here for you to check out if you're interested, but I really love this. I just wanted to show you guys because it is part of my little, you know, my little haul, my little collective haul. So the next bag, small leather good, I want to talk about, it's my Toiletry Pouch 15, I believe. I got this one maybe a month and a half ago, before, once I realized they were discontinuing these. It was the last one left. I think I told you guys this before in one of my videos, but yeah, you guys have heard me talk about toiletry pouches in almost all of my videos. I absolutely love this. I carry this in my bag, especially in my Alma BB. Whatever bag I have with me, this is in there. Sometimes I carry makeup, sometimes I carry feminine products, depending on what I need at the time. So definitely I love this. It is super cute with the vachetta right here. I love the little hint of it. My 26 still has its shape, and everything just still looks intact. So the next two small leather goods, little bags I want to show you, they're from Saint Laurent. This one as well, you guys have seen because I featured it in my new items from Farfetch video. I'll link that up here. But this is my little card holder. Very nice, super classy, in a classic style. I love it a lot. Sometimes a little more than my Louis Vuitton one because it has more slots to put cards. Next bag that I want to talk about is also from YSL. This is not really a bag, it's more of a clutch. I think it's called an envelope pouch. I have mistaken it for an Uptown pouch, but I realized for the price that I got this, the Uptown pouches are just a little more expensive. This is my YSL. I think I featured this. What did I feature it? Maybe in my Farfetch video as well. I did a video, a Get Ready With Me video, where I styled this clutch for you guys. I'll link it up here and you guys can check it out. I really like this. It fits my phone, it fits my necessities, and it's super cute. But do keep in mind that this material right here, it can get dirty pretty fast, but I take good care of it and I keep it in the dust bag when I'm not using it. So we're moving pretty fast. We're gonna move on to jewelry. The very first one I want to talk about, it's one from Dior. It's this little bracelet right here. I don't remember the name of it, but I'll put the name on the screen for you guys to see. It says CD on there, where it looks like little crystals, and it is adjustable depending on your wrist size. I have to say it's not gold, it's more of a rustic gold kind of, but it matches pretty well with the rest of my gold jewelry. So the next one I want to show you is from Hermes, and this is a click clack H bracelet. I'm wearing it today. I got mine in the white color. This is a new addition to my collection. I think I got this about 2 months ago, 2.5 months ago. If you're gonna get one, keep in mind it scratches easily, you guys. The very first day I got it and the very first time I wore it, it got a scratch. I stopped wearing it for a little while, but I just love it so much that I'm just gonna endure the scratches that it's gonna get. I mean, I guess, but the jewelry just gets scratches, especially if you're using them, you're using your hand and all of that. It happens. My Cartier bracelet has scratches. Well, not my bracelet. Whew. Speak it into existence, baby. My Cartier ring, my rings, they have scratches on them, but when I clean them, they look shiny again. So it's perfectly fine, but you know, just be careful and try to wear it on the hand you don't use as much. The next jewelry piece from Chanel. Now I know some of you guys must have seen this already because I did a little unboxing in a vlog. I think my last vlog or something. I keep it in the box. And these are double C earrings. Mine is, one C is with pearl and the other C have crystals. I think it's super, super cute. It's more of a champagne gold color. I do want to have a collection of Chanel jewelry because I think they're just so timeless, so chic, so classy, and such a classic thing to have. And I feel like Chanel pieces just add a little something to any outfit. Like what I'm wearing right now, if I had a Chanel earring on, banging, you know what I'm saying? So I absolutely love it, you guys. At first when I got it, I thought it was just a little too big, but it's only because I just wasn't used to seeing myself wearing earrings like this, because it's kind of like a stud, but it's pretty big. So that's why I thought it was big, but I think it's super cute and it looks very nice every time I wear it. The next one is from Louis Vuitton. You guys saw my vlog, then you would have known what this is. We got ourselves the LV Louise earrings. These are super popular. I know you've seen these everywhere. And if you guys watch my wishlist video, I did mention that I wanted these, and I feel like they're just a piece to have in your collection. So I am super, super happy that I have them. When I went to the store, they were the last one left. These are very sought after pieces. So sometimes on the website, it just sells out pretty quickly. And then the stores, you might get lucky if they have one last pair left. So I'm very happy that I got these. Super, super cute. I have two more jewelry pieces to show you guys. This one is from Rejuri. This is the croissant cuff. I really wanted this because I feel like it matches perfectly with the rest of my jewelry collection. It's just a nice little statement bangle cuff situation that's just not doing too much. Last piece of jewelry is an anklet. I got it from Miranda Fry. It's like a beaded anklet because I'm so obsessed with my other one that I got from them as well. So yeah, if you guys are looking for some anklets, and I do shower with mine, I wear it every single day and it has not tarnished yet, and I've had it for maybe a couple of months now. So if you guys are looking for, you know, jewelry pieces that will last and maybe some nice anklets and things, you can definitely check Miranda Fry as well. I believe that's it for jewelry. I'm gonna get into sunglasses. The very first one I have here is these nice, these are so nice. These are from Free People. As you can see, they have the clear frame right here with the gold around, and these are some brown, kind of like gradient almost, but not really, but they're like brown lenses, and you can definitely rock these. I mean, excuse me, okay? Like, these are so nice with the right outfit, the right, you know, hairdo. You will definitely just be looking like a star. And they were very inexpensive. They were about $25, but they took a while to get here. A while. Like, I'm not kidding. I ordered these in May, probably, or April, and I just recently got them. So The next shade I got here are from Key Australia. You guys must have seen me with these glasses. I've already worn them in a vlog. They're kind of dirty, but ignore. I absolutely love these glasses. When I saw them, I first saw them at Nordstrom. And I was like, oh, you know, I don't need any more glasses. Whatever, yada, yada, yada. Once I got home, I went straight to the website on Key Australia and I ordered these because I couldn't stop thinking about them. I think they just super cute. I think it's the gradient effect for me. How over here is super dark and then down there is clear. And then the handle here is like a leopard. It's like a turquoise color actually. And these are called blocked. Period. I don't know if you guys know, but I am a sunglasses junkie. I have so many sunglasses and I love to just wear them during the summer. I think in the summer, the sun is out, you need sunglasses, okay? So the next ones I have here are fairly new to my collection. These are from Fendi. If you saw my styling video, I styled those in that video. They look like this. They're pretty oversized and I love them. They're like a turquoise color as well. Oh, is it? It's not turquoise, it's turquoise. It has the Fendi logo right here, so it's not doing too much. To me, it's just doing enough. You guys know how I feel about things that are a little bit extra but just enough. So these are exactly that for me and I absolutely love them. All right, you guys, so we're almost done and now we're gonna move on to perfumes. And I got about three to show you guys and all of them are for Tom Ford. Well, they're not all from Tom. Okay, let's get into it. The first one I have here is Tom Ford Bitter Peach. You guys know the story behind this one. I never used to like it, then Britney turned me out, so now I like it. Okay, boom. So I love this. I really, really love this one. It smells really good. So a 50 ml bottle. This color is absolutely gorgeous. I love orange for anything summer. This is super, super cute and I'm so happy that I got it. The next two perfumes that I got, I'm gonna show you guys together because they're from the same brand. This is from Dossier. I have here Oriental Tobacco and Oriental Cherry. Oriental Cherry is inspired by Tom Ford Lost Cherry and Oriental Tobacco is inspired by Tom Ford Tobacco Vanille. I absolutely love, 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 love these perfumes. The Oriental Tobacco is my favorite, you guys. Like, I love it so much. It has like a masculine scent when you first spray it and then it dries down to a nice vanilla scent. I love this one. And this Lost Cherry one, same story as the Bitter Peach. I didn't used to like it, now I love it. For these perfumes, for some reason, this in Oriental Cherry one gives me a hint of Baldafrique, like a hint, undertone of it. It's pretty good, you guys. So definitely check these out. Everything will be linked down below. And for these, I do have a coupon code. I'll also leave it down below. We're literally almost done. I'm gonna get into... Oh, wait. When I did the bags, I forgot to show you one bag. The biggest bag of them all. It's a bag from Coach. It came in this beautiful box right here. I kept it wrapped because I just feel like this is such a pretty wrapping. Ugh, I love this. It did come with a dust bag, but this is the bag. You guys have seen this bag before. This is the Willow Tote from Coach. And I got this in black for work. This is specifically for work. I wanted to invest in a good black tote for work. So yeah, you guys, I am a nurse and this carries all of my necessities, all of them, and even more. Okay, so this is really, really good and it was pretty inexpensive comparing to luxury bags, luxury tote prices.
this was pretty more on the affordable side. So check this out in my best luxury purchases under 500. I'll link it up here for you guys to check out. I definitely featured this because I think this is definitely worth it. It's under 500 and it's pretty good so far. I've had it for maybe 2 months, a month and a half, and I have no complaints. The next things that I would like to talk about are scarves. I have a bunch here because I've been buying scarves like crazy. I have another one on the way. I just couldn't wait, so I just did the video, the collective haul, so I'll just add it in my next collective haul. Like I told you guys, I'll do these maybe every 2 months or so if I have enough to show. These are scarves. Most of them are from Banana Republic. Some are from Ann Taylor. I'm not showing my Louis Vuitton one here because I didn't just buy it, but these are just recent purchases, so that's why I'm showing them to you. This is from Banana Republic. It's a pretty burgundy, sienna, and beige color. This one I think you guys have seen. It has a lot of flowers, oranges, purple, yellow. I think this is pretty cute. This is from Ann Taylor. And then I got this one from Banana Republic, this one from Banana Republic, and this one from Banana Republic. I have a nice Tory Burch little nano bag that's supposed to come soon. It was on pre-order, so I think it's coming all the way in like September. But it has a nice green color and I am ready to receive it, because I plan on wearing this scarf with that bag. I think it would look super cute. I can't wait to style it for you guys. The next thing that I wanna show you guys is, the next two things actually I wanna show you guys. One of them is a household product and the next one is tech related thing. So the household product is not near me, but it is a Jo Malone diffuser. Oh my God, you guys, it smells absolutely amazing. It takes over the house, and I have an apartment, so it's not super, super big, but it takes over the house. And when you're sitting next to it, you can just get whiffs of the smell. And I think it's super cute. I got it on sale at Macy's, and I'm actually waiting on another sale to stock up on them, or maybe a Sephora sale to stock up on them. I never knew they were that good, but they're good, girl. Like, I love them. Let me see if I can get it for you to show you guys. Hold on. I just don't want it to spill, because you guys know I'm clumsy. It's right here, you guys. This one is the pomegranate noir. This is an amazing, amazing, amazing diffuser. I absolutely love to have this in my house. As you can see, it's going, baby. It's going. I don't know how long it's gonna last. I've heard some people say 6 months, 9 months, 1 year. Apparently, it's supposed to. I've heard mostly 1 year. So we're gonna see, but for me, I love it in the house. Last but not least, it is a tech thing. You guys probably don't know because I don't talk about it much, but my laptop gave out on me since about last year. I was usually using my desktop, but sometimes you feel so confined. And if I'm out and about, I can't edit a video unless I'm home because I don't have a laptop that is functioning. So finally, I got myself a new laptop and I also got a case. So this is the Apple laptop that I got. I got a MacBook Pro and I got an in-case case. I know this color seems like it'll get dirty super fast, but it's the material that it is in is definitely easy to clean. So all you have to do is just wipe it ever so often and then you should be good. But I absolutely love this, so now I can edit on the go. I can edit in my living room. I can edit wherever I please. Okay, and I'm super, super happy. And I got this on sale, you guys, since I think they're coming out with newer ones. So Best Buy had these on sale. I think I saved about $300. So that was a pretty good deal. We're happy. So this is the end of the video, you guys. I want to thank you so much for watching. Thank you for hanging out with me. Don't forget to like, comment,
and subscribe down below. Share this video with your friends and family if you found it helpful, of course. And I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Bye.